Hello friends, welcome to BSc Agriculture. If you are coming to my channel for the first time, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button. So let's move to the video. In this video, we are going to see about productive cultivation and secondary agriculture. I am going to cover the topic physical properties of the agricultural commodities. So first we can able to get a small intro about why we are going to study about the physical properties. So physical properties are nothing but the engineering properties. So which are useful for making the design as well as the operation unit for the agriculture processing in the field level. So these basic informations are said to be more important and helpful for engineers as well as food scientists and processors, so that they can able to make an efficient process as well as the efficient development of agricultural processing units. So these attempts are said to be made for describing the some of the engineering properties which are said to be encountered in post harvesting handling of agriculture crops are also said to be maintained. So let's move to the physical properties. So the physical properties which we are mainly useful for studying of different agricultural commodities are shape and size, density and specific gravity, mass and 1000 seeds per grain weight. So if they were in seeds, and volume, porosity, density, friction and the angle of repose. So these are the physical properties which we use to collect data from each and every agriculture commodities, and some other properties which are said to be need in consideration while checking about the engineering properties are aero and hydrodynamic properties, which is the terminal velocity of the agriculture commodities, and the electrical and dielectric properties. So we can now go for the sessions. So while saying about shape and size, so the first one is roundness and the second one is sphericity. So the roundness is nothing but the measure of the sharpness of the solid material. So it describes about the sharpness, even it used to have a smooth end as well as the roughest end. So it was all said to be measured in the roundness. And sphericity, which is nothing but the ratio of diameter and the sphere of the same volume of the particular particle and the smallest circumference of the sphere, which is generally to the particle size of the diameter. So I gave them in an equation form for roundness. So roundness, it is nothing but the largest productive area of a particle when it is in rest position, divided by the area of the largest circumference of the circle. So it is how the roundness is calculated. And roundness ratio is nothing but the radius of the curvature of the sharpest corner divided by mean radius of the circle is said to be measured in the roundness ratio. And sphericity, so sphericity formula is dE by dC or dI by dC. So dE is nothing but the diameter of the sphere which you use it to have the largest particle having same volume, and dI the largest inscribing circle in the particle, and dC which is the smallest circumference circle created by the particle. So it is how the sphericity is calculated. And while seeing about shape, which is the another important thing, so shape is said to be the important part. Important property to specify the geometry of the crop. So the most important packaging designs as well as the sieve for grading and separations are said to be described mainly by the shape of the particular particle. So the different shapes are round, oblate, oblong, conic, ovate, regular and irregular forms. So these are different shapes which we have studied in the agriculture properties. And the next one is density and specific gravity. So while saying about density, it is nothing but the weight of the material divided by volume of the material. So the measuring units are kilogram divided by m3. And the specific gravity, so while saying about the specific gravity, weight in air into specific gravity of water divided by weight of the displaced water. So the specific gravity is mainly calculated by water displacement method. So it's how the specific gravity is calculated. And mass, so the mass of is said to be the agriculture material which is usually important to design the handling system. So it is mainly expressed in gram, kilogram, quintal and tons. So the mass is said to be increased with the moisture content. So the water used to add mass for the material in the agriculture commodities. And the next one is 1000 seed per grain weight. So it is usually measure the number as well as the mass in different grains. So these are mainly done, these 1000 seed per grain weight are said to be mainly done for the grain products as well as the seed products. So for example, rice, wheat, it's how the 1000 seed weights and the grains are calculated and seed weight is to be done as mass in this measurement. So it is useful for required quantity of seeds or grain are said to be randomly picked and weighted usually. So the property which used to increase the moisture content and weights to the grain or seed must need to be increased when the moisture content is said to be increases. And the next one is volume. So volume is nothing but the substance which are estimated to have different dimensions. So the unit is meter cube, and the bulk density of the grain and which used to occupy the bulk volume and excluding the spore space, it is said to be known as true volume. So while classifying the volume we can able to classify them as two ones. So the bulk volume, which also includes the spore space. So in the pore space where there is a presence of air or some other particles can be excluded. But in true volume, the pore space is said to be excluded. So the pore space are cancelled by water. So it's where the water displacement method is said to be taken place, and the true volume is said to be weighted. And the next one is porosity. So porosity is said to be defined as the percentage of volume of intergranular space to the volume of grain bulk. So the porosity we can able to calculate them by void volume or pore volume divided by the total volume into 100%. So it is also done by water displacement method for the calculation of void or pore volume. And another thing is density. So density is nothing but the ratio of mass to the volume. So we can able to classify density as bulk density and true density. So bulk density is nothing but the ratio of mass of volume to the bulk material with the void space. In true density, the void space is said to be cancelled out. So it's how the true density, the bulk volume of mass material is said to be calculated. So true density is equal to bulk density divided by 1 minus porosity. It's how the true density is calculated. And the friction. So while seeing about friction, there are two types of friction, which is a static friction and kinetic friction. So the static friction, the friction said to be defined as the frictional force acting towards when there is a contact in between the rest surface of the agriculture product which is respect to each other. And the kinetic force is said to be the surface of relative motion which is said to be found in this agriculture product. Once the frictional force existed, is said to be known as the kinetic friction. So while calculating the kinetic friction, mu is equal to F bar W. So I can't able to find that letter, so I mark it as U, but it is a mu. And the other one is angle of repose. So the angle of repose is the angle between the base as well as the slope of the cone formed which has a free vertical fall of the granular material to the horizontal plane. So it's how the angle of repose is calculated. So it is defined as the angle made by the grain with a horizontal heap naturally. So there are two types of angular repose. So these angles are said to be mainly calculated for how the packaging process can be easily done. So the two angle of repose are static angle of repose and dynamic angle of repose. And the other thing is aero and hydrodynamic properties. So the aero and hydrodynamic properties are such as terminal velocity of the agriculture product are said to be important as well as a required one for designing and the air and water conveying systems as well as the separating equipments made for the agriculture commodities. So the physical properties such as density, shape and drag coefficient as well as porosity are which are said to be required for calculating the terminal velocity of the material. So the terminal velocity is nothing but the velocity which can be defined as equal to the air velocity at which the particular remains unsuspended state in a vertical pipe against gravity is said to be known as the terminal velocity of the agriculture commodity. And the other thing is electric and dielectric properties. So electrical and dielectric properties are said to be the conductance, resistance as well as capacitance of the agriculture commodity with the moisture content of the material. So it is the electrical properties which are mainly used for indirect determination of moisture content in the agriculture commodity, and the dielectric constant, loss tangent and dielectric loss factor are the dielectric properties which we are observing in the agriculture commodities. So these properties are mainly influenced by moisture content as well as the frequency of the agriculture commodities. So these properties, both the electric and dielectric properties, are much influenced by the moisture content. So these properties are exploited for measuring the moisture determination in the agriculture commodities. It's why these properties are said to be taken in conditions. So I have given the lecture notes in the description. Please comment about the video and join us in the Instagram page. If you like the video, like it and share it with your friends and subscribe to BSC Agriculture and hit the bell icon to get regular updates. So thanks for watching the video. I'll catch up in next videos.